Hi everybody, this is Shanna with shannasweetsblog.blogspot.com. Today I'm coming at you for my representing creativesoupforthesoul.ing.com. I've made several projects for swaps at Creative Soup, and I've used several products that Trish carries in the store there. So I'm getting ready to mail all these, so... And I don't know if I'll get this video up before some of these are due, we'll see. Turn my camera down, maybe. My tripod wants to cooperate. Oh, let's see. Let's use the back of this. This is for a charm swap. It was an individual one-on-one swap. And I believe my partner's name is Tracy, and she's in the UK. So I don't know if she'll get this by the due date. Hopefully, Postal Service won't. Take forever. First of all, I'm using just a journal spot that I received in a journal swap swap. So hey, don't ever, you know, participate in those things. You never know what you can use them for. But it was butterflies, and that matched my theme. I went with the butterfly theme because I bought some of these images, which I don't know if you can see a little butterfly. I got two different ones here. Bottle caps, and Trish is going to, hopefully soon we'll have the bottle caps in the store, but the images I got somewhere else on eBay, and then I just put glossy accents inside. I used my crocodile to punch a hole in the top and just slipped a jump ring through it. So that was the start of what I wanted to do with my charm swap, and then I looked and I had a bunch of other, I love butterflies, so I'm always getting butterfly charms. So, that's how I'm using Tim Holtz chain. I forgot what it's called now. And I just, you know, put in a couple crystals. Kind of went, didn't really, it kind of went with just, I don't know, pink and yellows. Kind of tried to match the colors in the images on the bottle caps. So, I'm not sure even where I got that one. I don't remember where I got that one at now. So, yep, so that's going to be my charm. Like I said, I just attached it to this little card that she can use for something else also. So that was for the charm swap. There is two different springtime swaps, and I can't figure out how, there we go. How to open. So I signed up for a springtime card swap. And this is my card. Back out a little bit again. So this is my card. I just used some nice pink paper. This little image is from MFT, My Favorite Things. She has a stamp. I was trying to debate. I don't know if they do digitals or not. I used three different little pieces of lace here, which didn't get these particular laces, but Trish has tons of laces, and I know she's getting more. I made a little rib rosette out of the pink paper, and I put a little like daisy punch on there, and then I've got, I don't know if you can see this, it's a little bitty aluminum flower. Kind of for the center point. And it just nice little daisy there. And then it just flips up. It's blank inside, so you can use it for any sort of greeting. And there's still lots of space here. If somebody wants to put a greeting at the top, they can. Then the spring tag swap. I used the glassine bags, which you can get at Trisha's store, and I stamped. This is a Tim Holtz stamp that I used distressed ink to stamp these, but I was going to spray them with some glimmer to make the bag shiny, and it totally, I don't know if these, I've sprayed I think it's just the waxy feel of the glassine bags. It just, especially on this bottom one, it just drooped. It just did not look right. So I redid that bag. But I did butterflies on my tag, so I had to put little butterflies on the bag itself. And here's my tag. I used cereal box to cut out the actual tag itself and then lined both sides with some bright yellow paper. The paper is from, it's some sort of Princess Stack. No, this is American Crafts. I'll take that back. This was an American Crafts pad. So I just have some loose little thin ribbon there. Big butterfly here at the top. It's got some glitter that wants to come off. This little pearl. I made my own little swirl with it, and you can get these little pearl strands at Trisha's store. And then I used the Tim Holtz die tag cutter to cut this out, and on that comes this frame. And so I cut out the frame with the chipboard, cereal chipboard. Then I painted it white, and then I sprayed it with Lindy's. I used a blue here, I think was pre-blue. And then on the circle part, I had originally done with one of the green tones, and I wanted a little more pink in there, so then I put a dabber with the pink. So it's kind of pink and green kind of mixed in there, because I was trying to bring out the colors in the paper. And then I used a purple Stampin' Up! Ink to put in this stamp Dream, and this stamp comes from my Creative Time with Emma. I think it's like inspiring words. Then this little pink is trim from Trisha's store, from the Creative Soup for the Soul store. And then of course the bling is also from the store. And then the little, which is little 5-point cloth flowers with the little pearl inside it, that also comes from the store. So I thought that's nice, pretty, cheerful tag. And then last, not least, is there's a journal swap. And I did something a little different this time. These are CD covers. And I made like, I made like a little book out of it. So I used some paper. This paper I got at Tuesday Mornings. Believe it or not, it was a Paris Hilton stack. I like the purples in it, so that's what I used. And so I just did the front. Used one of my punches for the corners. One of those corner chomper punches with the ticket stub. Used the bling to make one of those, the flowers that I like making for my hair things. I used that and some fabric for the center flower. A piece of lace at the bottom with some bling. So that bling is so easy to cut up. You can cut it in your cuddle bug. And I keep all my little scraps, because like for the tag, I didn't need much. I just used the scraps for when I made these flowers. So on the inside, you have, there's lots of space for pictures, and then I put in some tags on the one side, and then even on the other side here, I put nice blank tags so they can do journaling there, but there's lots of room for pictures. So it's almost like a little mini book, and it'll easily slide into a mini album, or put them together. I mean, you could easily hinge these to a spine and use them to make a mini album. Matter of fact, I have some, and that's my thought. I just haven't gotten around to it yet. So that's all my samples. Please join us at creativesoupforthesoul.ing.com. Lots of fun swaps going on and lots of great stuff in the store. And I know she's got a bunch of stuff coming over the next several weeks. So please check her out. Thanks. Bye.